tutorial Decode, and in today's class I will be decoding for a victim-centric approach, and this is written by Flavia Agnes. Before I do the decode of the editorial, I just want to tell you about something new that we have introduced on brainiki.com. Since yesterday, we have begun with a new approach to prepare for the current affairs, and accordingly we will be posting at least 4 questions on brainiki.com with respect to current affairs. The first day we have already posted the 4 questions, and these 4 questions have been picked up from the Hindu newspaper. There will be only 4 questions that we will be posting. The first one is, this is the application, and the first one is write about fiscal consolidation measures in India. Second one is write about new rules by Ministry of Environment and Forest with respect to granting forest clearances. Third is BCIM corridor and how it can be a game changer in South Asian trade. And the fourth is write a note on the string of pearls and maritime silk trade route. Now, we have already posted the current affairs in the form of questions, and we've written the answer on it. So all the subscribers, EIES mentors and Brainiki subscribers, they are requested to keep a track of what all we'll be posting on brainiki.com. And a very important announcement for the students who are my subscribers, who are my paid subscribers and about my video classes, they are requested to be in touch with me on a regular basis via WeChat, via video chat on the Sundays. So Sundays I have kept it for taking up the calls from my students, so they requested to call me at a Hangout. This is the application, Google application Hangout. They can contact me by just adding my account. For that they have to add in my email address. My email address is brainiki@gmail.com. So let us start with the decode for a victim-centric approach. Now this is a kind of a topic that will help you in social issues. This is about the life. This is about how the victim gets further victimized. Although this editorial has dealt about the victimization of a victim from one perspective, ek hi perspective se deal kiya hai, but I will be delineating more number of dimensions by which a victim further gets victimized. Now, before I do this victimization process, how a victim gets victimized, it is important to understand what is a rape. Rape is something that is not physical. Rape is not only an intrusion into something. Rape is not only getting physical. Rape is actually hitting at the social life of the victim. Rape is actually hitting at the psychological life of a victim. Rape is actually hitting at the psyche of the victim. Rape is actually hitting at the livelihood of a victim. She finds it difficult to join any profession because she gets psychologically down. She feels depressed. The society gets alienated. Nobody wants to be a party with a rape victim. There is a degeneration of the mind. The soul gets brutal up. Now this editorial, it deals with that how a victim-centric approach should be adopted so that the victims, rights So this editorial is all about the vulnerability that a victim has to face after she has been raped. Now, what are the different type of vulnerabilities? What are the different types of social stigmas that a rape victim has to face? The number one stigma is the stigma of the society. The society never allows, never absorbs the rape victim as it absorbs a normal person. And second is with respect to the police administration. How the police administration behaves with the rape victim, that adds to the social and the psychological agony. These are the agonies that gets incepted once a rape is done, and these are further multiplied, these are further magnified by the society, by the police, and by actually by our criminal justice system. When I talk about criminal justice system, it means a victim feels further victimized because of the delinquencies, misadministration and maladministration of the police, and the way the justice is conferred to the rape victim. So it is about society, it is about police, and it is about judiciary. Rape victim feels half lost from the society. And this victim-centric approach wants to provide a regenerative and a rehabilitative process to a rape victim so that she can easily mainstream her mind and her soul with the society. Because something such has been done with her that she was not ready to accept. So rehabilitation is a very important thing. And the most important thing in the rehabilitation process is the social rehabilitation. Social acceptability by the society. The social acceptability will lead to the psychological acceptability. The psychological acceptability will help her to join the mainstream society. She will be able to proceed with her livelihood resources. She will be able to continue with her studies. She will be able to get some job. So, what is important in this victim-centric approach is that we need to bring about, the number one is the social changes. We need to bring about the social changes. We need to bring about the changes and the reforms in the police. We need to bring about the changes in the way the justice is conferred onto the victim, the way the trial is conducted, the way the defense lawyers should be sensitized. So judicial reforms, police reforms, it is actually the procedural reforms in the judiciary, the procedural reforms in the police. And apart from that, we need to introduce more dissuading laws jo stop kar sake in cheezon ko. We need to uplift the society morally. We need to morality wise, ethics wise, so that the degeneration of the society don't lead to such aberrations. And the fast justice is the most important thing in order to stifle such aberrations in the society. These are the societal aberrations. These are the human errors. And human errors can be amended, can be corrected, can be rectified by human efforts. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can contact me at 845-94-000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation, general studies prelims and general studies mains. And you can avail further information about the classes that I am offering at eiasmentors.com and at brainiki.com. And the subscribers are requested to stay in touch, keep a track of brainiki.com on a continuous basis. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.